In this video, we are going to implement multiplexer circuit. First of all, what is multiplexer? Multiplexer is logic circuit that select one out of several data inputs to give single output. And that input selection is dependent on number of set of select inputs. This multiplexer is widely used combinational circuit in digital design. Multiplexer is also called as many into one. Its equation is D3S1S0 plus D2S1S0 bar plus D1S1 bar S0 plus D0S1 bar S0. So using this equation, first of all, we will implement its circuit. So go into inputs, select logic input, and this is S0. This first input is S0. So we will place it in an appropriate position. So this is our S1 input. We required inverter also. So connect inverter over here. So this line will be treated as S1 bar. So connect it with the wire. So now this line is treated as S1 bar. Same thing we will do it for S0. So S0 is this. So we need to change its direction. So like this, okay. So use wire for doing connection, okay. In between this, we need to use inverter, place it at appropriate position and connect it. Use wire for getting S0 bar. So this will be treated as S0. So let us represent it. So this is your S1 suppose, and the next input is S0. Okay. So this is bar, so this one will be treated as S1 bar and this is S0 bar. Now we'll be requiring 4 AND gate. So first of all, we'll take AND gate. So go into logic gates and select AND gate option. So AND gate, 4 AND gates are required for that matter. And number of inputs to this AND gate is 3. Now after this we will do the connection, okay, and output of this AND gate is connected to OR gate. So go into logic gates option and select OR gate. Now input to this OR gate will be 4. So place it appropriately and then do the connection. Use wire for connecting these two gates. So when you are getting any red color dot, that indicates the connection is not appropriate. In the circuit mode software, only dot to dot connections are allowed. Now to check the output, we'll be using LED as output device. So connect that LED at the output and add ground terminal to that. Now first input to this AND gate is D3. So we'll select logic inputs and from there we'll be connecting our first input. So this one will be treated as our D3. Then, since we don't want this connection, I will remove that wire. Then we'll select second AND gate, its input is D2. So this will be treated as D2. Then third is D1. So first input to third AND gate is D1 and first input to fourth AND gate is D0. So this one will be treated as D3, D2, D1 and D0. Okay. Now we need to do the connection for this first AND gate to S1 and S0. So we'll connect or we'll take input is not required. So we'll require wire. So we'll select wire. So this is our S1. So we'll do that connection from here to the second input of first AND gate. And third input of first AND gate should be connected to S0. So this is our S0. So we'll take a wire and we'll do the dot to dot connection. So first AND gate connections are over. Now we'll move towards the second AND gate. D2 is already connected. We need to connect S1. So here we have our S1. So we'll use the same input and we'll connect it to the second input of second AND gate. Now third input of this AND gate should be connected to S0 bar. So we'll take one wire from S0 bar and we'll do this connection. Okay. Then third AND gate connection, D1 is already connected, S1 bar. So this is our S1 bar. So we'll take one wire from S1 bar and then we'll do the connection. Then third input to this third AND gate should be connected to S0 and this is our S0 line. So we'll connect it. Now input connections are over for third AND gate. We'll move towards the fourth AND gate. D0 is already connected. Now we need to connect S1 bar and S0 bar. So this is our S1 bar and we'll connect it to second input of fourth NAND gate. And this is S0 bar which is connected to third input of fourth NAND gate. So this is complete circuit. If you want to represent appropriately, you can definitely add text over here. That is, this is our D3. Then we have D1, D2. Then this is our D1 and last is D0. Now we'll see working of this circuit. So as you can see in this diagram, these two are select lines. Depending upon the data applied to the select lines, one of the input is selected. So here four inputs are there, that's why it is called as 4:1 multiplexer and one output is there. Depending upon set of select lines, we'll be getting output.